أنزله ورسول الله معلمنا ورسول الله معلمنا
القرآن يوحدنا لطريق الخير يوجهنا الله تعالى أنزله ورسول الله معلمنا ورسول الله معلمنا
للعلم وللعمل. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We are still pondering upon the beautiful verses of Surah Al-A'la. Allah Azza wa Jal says in ayah number 9, فَذَكِّرْ إِن نَفَعَتِ الذِّكْرَى. Remind in case the reminders benefit them. And this is an order to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that cascades well as well with us. It is our job to remind. It is not our job to force people. Our job is to give reminders, to give eye-openers, to guide people by showing them the path and the way. And the people who are reminded are divided into two types. Allah says, سَيَذَّكَّرُ مَنْ يَخْشَى, that the reminder will be received by him who fears Allah Azza wa Jal. So this is part one, those who benefit. And then Allah says, وَيَتَجَنَّبُهَا الْأَشْقَى, but it will be avoided by the wretched, the losers, by the miserable ones who give away their right in paradise. So these are the second type who would refuse guidance when it comes to them. And as a consequence, Allah says, الَّذِي يَصْلَى النَّارَ الْكُبْرَى, those are the ones who will enter the great fire and made to taste its burning. They're wretched, its burning. They're wretched because they will enter hell. And this is by choice. They're the one who chose this evil way, this evil path, when they rejected the reminders that came to them. So many eye-openers, so many reminders came to their doors and they locked these doors. What would happen to them in that grand fire, in that grand torment of burning blazes? And why is it grand? Because there's nothing bigger than it in the sense of torment and punishment. On earth we have fire, and this fire is one out of 70 branches of hellfire. So it's nothing compared to hellfire. And what will happen to those who enter it? Allah says, ثُمَّ لَا يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَى, wherein he will neither die nor live. And this is quite shocking. How is it possible that a person would be in a state that it is not living nor dying? What we know of is you're either alive or dead. Well, in hell, people would not be living nor dying. It's something that we cannot comprehend or understand. But they are in a state that they cannot live and enjoy life. If someone in this life is paralyzed neck down and he has debts, and the police is always coming and asking for people's money, his wife cheats on him, his son is a drug addict, his daughter is a prostitute, these calamities are as heavy as the mountains. If you go to him and say, Akhi, say Alhamdulillah, you're still alive, he would shout at you and say, what kind of a life is it? This is nothing compared to the torment and punishment in hell. So they will neither die or live in hell. They would not die in the sense that death should terminate any type of torment or punishment. When you're dead, you don't feel a thing. So if there's a dead corpse in front of you and you kick it and you jump on it, it's not gonna say a single word. Those who are in hell, they're neither alive, they're neither enjoying living, nor they are dead, and everything would be over for them. Then Allah Azza wa Jal talks to us after mentioning those who are in hell, talk to us about the believers, those who took the reminders and embraced them, those who believed in the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى. He has indeed benefited, he has succeeded, who purified himself. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى. The one who purifies his soul, by far he had succeeded. And we spoke about success in previous episodes. And as a reminder, success is not limited to what you find in this life. A beautiful wife, a big mansion, a number of cars, a wealthy, big, fat bank account, your health, your wealth, your offspring. This is not how you measure success. Maybe by this worldly standards, this would be acceptable. But by the standards of Allah, this is not success. Allah says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازْ. Whoever is turned away from hell and admitted to paradise, he has succeeded. And this is the success that we want and we look for. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ. He has succeeded. مَنْ تَزَكَّى. Whoever purifies his heart and soul. And such a purification is done only through Islam. In the authentic hadith, the Prophet says, عليه الصلاة والسلام, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ أَسْلَمْ وَرُزِقَ كَفَافًا وَقَنَّعَهُ اللَّهُ بِمَا آتَاهُ. He indeed has succeeded who embraces Islam. And Allah provides His provision sufficiently, enough, not overwhelmingly, but he gets his provisions, that is enough. And thirdly, Allah grants him the content and satisfaction with what he has given him. You have multi-billionaires who are not content with what they have. And you have poor people, farmers, people with low wage, and they're so happy and content that it breaks your heart. When you walk in some Muslim countries and you see that mid-aged man on his bicycle, clean shirt, nice trousers, very good tie, he's got oil on his hair, nicely combed, and he's going to work. And you know that he works 10 hours a day in a low pay position. Yet you can see in his face the happiness and the content. He goes back to his home, to his wife, to his children, did some shopping, brought some fruit, some vegetables, nothing fancy. No cakes or chocolate ice cream, the standard. Yet you see the content. You see the happiness, the satisfaction he has in his heart. And this is a blessing and a favor from Allah Azza wa Jal. This is success. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. And remembers the name of his Lord and prays. Some scholars say that this is the title and the definition of success and purification of the soul. That you remember Allah and you pray. Because it is unimaginable for a person to have a pure heart and soul without remembering Allah Azza wa Jal and without prayer. The Prophet said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, the similitude, the resemblance between someone who remembers Allah and someone who doesn't is like a living person and a dead person. Remembering Allah Azza wa Jal is the best of deeds. How would I remember Allah? By saying Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, Astaghfirullah. All of these are parts of remembering Allah. Praising Allah, glorifying Allah is remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. Even what you do, because just remembering by saying it is unlike the general concept of remembering Allah when you apply this into actions. So if I pray, if I fast, this is remembering Allah Azza wa Jal, and it would lead me to what pleases Allah, the Almighty. We have a short break, so stay tuned.
The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqoo mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'ah.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Beast TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace Team, the solution for humanity.
Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Solution or problem? Heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half or Bitter Half every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV.
We are not addicted to dawah. Addiction implies a short-term fix. One doesn't need to get into the zone to talk about Islam. You do dawah because it is a natural result of your commitment to Allah. If you don't talk, people are going to walk. The most effective combination in the propagation of true Islam is found in Dawah Ilallah. Join me, Arif Islam, as we go through Dawah Ilallah only on Peace TV.
Follow the tips to make the task of Dawah result-oriented in Dawah Ilallah next on Peace TV.
Hadha al-Qur'an huwa al-hadi. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back. So he who remembers Allah Azza wa Jal, he is the one who has succeeded in purifying his soul. And also by praying, وَذَكَرَ اسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. And prayer is on the top of the list. This purifies your soul. It enlarges, increases iman in your heart. And the best of all types of prayers are the five daily prayers. These are the pillars of Islam. Your night prayer, your voluntary prayer, all of these are not as important or essential as the five daily prayers. Allah Azza wa Jal says after that, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. Nay, you prefer the life of this world. Which means that people do not purify themselves, do not remember Allah Azza wa Jal, do not seek success and prayer because they prefer this world. They prefer what they see. And this is our problem. Our problem is with the lack of iman, the lack of conviction. If we believed that it is all with Allah Azza wa Jal, we would have sought it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when we see the food, the drinks, the money, the power, the women in this life, we see it in front of us. It's within our grasp. It's within our taking. And then we recall what Allah has prepared for us. It depends on the level of your belief. If it is weak, you will disregard what you see, hoping in what you do not see, because you believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. But man is created of haste. He wants everything now, not later. Allah told us Azza wa Jal, you prefer the life of this world. However, Allah says, وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبَقَى. Although the hereafter is better and more lasting. Do you believe in this? I believe. All Muslims believe that what Allah Azza wa Jal has is better and far greater than what we see in this world. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad said, and it's also reported that Malik ibn Dinar, may Allah have mercy on them, they said the same statement, that if this world was made of gold that would fade away, and the hereafter is made of clay that would stay, any person with logic would prefer the thing that is cheap and would stay over that is expensive and would be taken away. But the fact is, this world is made of clay and it will go away, while the hereafter is made of gold that would be everlasting and would never ever end. So what will you choose? Allah Azza wa Jal told us that you prefer this dunya over what is better and more lasting. And this is human nature. Allah says, إِنَّ هَذَا لَفِي الصُّحُفِ الْأُولَى صُحُفِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى. Verily, this is in the former scriptures, the scriptures of Ibrahim and Musa, peace be upon them. What is in the scriptures? Some say it is Surat Al-A'la itself. It is found in the scriptures. And others say, no, this is not what was intended. It is rather that you prefer the life of this world, although the hereafter is better and more lasting. These two ayahs, the instruction they hold within, these are found in the scriptures of Ibrahim and Musa, peace be upon them. And this is all what the messengers of Allah had brought to their people, reminding them of what Allah has prepared for the righteous and the pious, telling them that this life is just a phase. It's just a moment that would soon fade away. And what would remain is your deeds and what you have done. And this is a great reminder that the Prophet ﷺ used to recite in every night in his witr prayer, and also on Fridays, and also in the Eids. In great occasions when the people would gather, he would recite this surah, because every single ayah in it captures you, draws you closer to Allah Azza wa Jal, opens your eye. It opens your eyes to what is around you, the purpose of your existence, and where you will be going to after you die. From these ayahs, we learn that Allah Azza wa Jal is encouraging us to purify ourselves and to remember Him and to offer prayers on time. The best deeds an individual can do and the most beloved deeds to Allah Azza wa Jal is when we offer these prayers to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also in these ayahs, we learn that Allah Azza wa Jal is showing us the reality of this world, and it's not worthy of living for, and that we are not here to stay. The Prophet used to say, alayhi salatu wasalam, I am merely like a traveler who on his way saw a tree, so he took a short nap in its shade and then kept on traveling. This is life. It's a small portion. It's a pause that you take, and then you resume your eternal life, whether in paradise or in hell. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us among those who are in paradise and prevent us from being among those who are in hell. This is life that Allah Azza wa Jal is telling us not to live for, but rather to live for what is after this life. Look forward. Allah Azza wa Jal, in so many verses in the Quran, explains that to us clearly, that this life is a transitional period. It's a test. And depending on what you do in this life, this would determine, with the grace of Allah Azza wa Jal, your adob, whether in hell or in heaven. So don't enjoy life as if you are living forever. On the contrary, always be prepared, always have your bags packed, because you will travel the minute you get the call. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has instructed his companion and brother-in-law Abdullah ibn Umar when he grabbed his shoulders once and said, كن في الدنيا كأنك غريب أو عابر سبيل. Be in this life as if you are a stranger, a total stranger, in a city or in a village, or a passerby. If a traveler is passing by a village, he's going from destination A to C, and he passes by village B, just going through. The most he would do would probably buy a bottle of water and some food, get some fuel and move on. This is the norm. But if he decides to stay, get married, build a house, would he be traveling? The answer is no. If a slave was sent on an errand by his master, and instead of doing what his master told him to do, he bought a house and got married and settled down, he would be punished for that. This life is exactly the same. Allah had sent us to this life, ordered us to do few things, worship Him, stay away from haram, and if we do and succeed in doing that, then we will go to paradise forever. If not, then you know what would happen. And finally, all the books of Allah Azza wa Jal, whether it is the Quran, it is the Injil, it is the Torah, it is the scriptures of Musa or Ibrahim, they all include the reality of this life and the final destination of all human beings. It all includes calling people to Allah, to believe in His oneness, to worship Him and no one else with Him, It all includes what benefits the Muslims, the believers, the followers of these scriptures. It's all the same because it is from the same source. It is from Allah Azza wa Jal. However, Allah did not pledge to preserve the previous scriptures as He did with the Quran. In the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that it is He who descended and revealed this dhikr, this Quran, and it is Allah Azza wa Jal who would protect it and preserve it. So if you believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, you have to believe in the Quran, the final revelation and testament. With this, we come to the conclusion of this episode. Until we meet next time, fi amanillah. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.